Let's start by talking about the Pope. You've been in that House of Representatives many times when big picture people have talked. The Pope went in today. Your friend John Boehner had some tears in his eyes. Joe Biden had some tears in his eyes. The Pope talked about Dorothy Day, Thomas Merton, Martin Luther King, and Abraham Lincoln. It's the four-figure speech. What did you make of the Pope and of his visit thus far, Governor Kasich?
Oh, hey, it's you. I love the Pope. And I watched, I didn't see all of it, but I saw a big chunk of him. And look, here's why I love the Pope. He's throwing open the doors of the church. He's saying to people that the Lord Almighty is a God of grace and a God of love and a God of human potential. And he says that, which these are all the things I believe so strongly in. And he says that what we do on this earth today will be measured against us tomorrow. And it's all about human potential. It's all about living a life greater than ourselves. And look, you see the throngs, the people. Why? Because he represents hope. He represents holiness. He represents good things. And I just think he's just fantastic. I mean, he drives around in that little Pope-mobile. He has very little security. He said that the Lord put him there and the Lord should protect him. He, you know, he lives in a little apartment there in Vatican City. I mean, he walks the walk, talks the talk, and, you know, I just think he's terrific.
I agree with you. I said at the debate, you're running an up with people campaign, and that was an up with people and the Pope campaign answer, but it's genuine. Everybody genuinely likes him. I refuse to politicize this because he's not political.
Look, I think. Let me tell you some of my interpretations. First of all, Saint Francis of Assisi and Francis Schaeffer. I don't know if you know Francis Schaeffer.
Oh, you bet.
One of the great theologians of the 20th century. Both of them have talked about the need for us to protect God's creation. We're not to worship it. We're not to do extreme things, but we have to be aware of it. Okay? I mean, that's what I get out of what he says, and I think that's appropriate. Secondly, what else does he talk about? He talks about blatant materialism, that, you know, we should not be about collecting things. And that doesn't mean you can't have fine art or great music or whatever, but you can't worship things. You got to worship the Lord. And, you know, when he talks about capitalism, and I think he's kind of moved off of that, you know, the one thing, if I ever had a chance to have a long dinner with him or something, I would say, look, capitalism has rescued more people from poverty than any system known to man. Now, but I think what he's driving at, I don't want to put words in his mouth, and neither should the press. You know, a free enterprise system has to be underlaid with a set of values. Michael Novak wrote that. You know Michael Novak, Hugh.
You bet. Greatest
Catholic theologians. He's received the Templeton Prize. I love that. And when he talks about everybody being made in the image of God, I tell you, I was on a treadmill watching this thing, and I just found my just joy creeping up in my body as I looked at those people that stood on the mall, and they just wanted to see him. And the children, you know, the way that the children have been. He's talked about the children and the way he talks about the family, you know, and how he said, God bless America, right? Have dreams. It's great.
It is great.
You can see, I'm very pumped up about this. I am really excited about this.